I greet you, dear viewer, in the mighty name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I hope you are fine and the Lord has kept you safe. And we would like to thank him for this Father he has brought us. We'd like to welcome you in our 100 Days of Prayer series. We are calling upon Jesus is our urgent need. And today, being day 77, we want to thank God for this Father he has brought us. Today's focus comes from the book of Acts 1, verse 8. Acts 1, verse 8. And the theme or the title of our discussion or all of our devotion today is Empowered to Serve. Empowered to serve. Shall we pray as we start this devotion? Our kind and loving Master in heaven, we are grateful and thankful for the opportunity you have granted unto us today to listen unto thy word and to bring our prayers and our supplications unto thee. We can't take this for granted that we are breathing. You have given us the gift of life. For those who have slept, they are not better than, we are not better than them, but Jehovah God, it is through your mercies that we are alive at this moment. Thank you for my dear viewer. As we go through this, may your holy presence abide with us so that the word that we will hear will find a place in our hearts, and this word will draw us closer and closer to thee. It is in Jesus' name we have prayed and given thanks. Amen. And amen. The book of Acts 1 verse 8, I would like you to open your scriptures and you follow. The book of Acts 1 verse 8, the Bible says, "But you shall receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you shall be witnesses to me in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Samaria and the end and to the end of the earth." Remember, these are words that Jesus was telling to the disciples. Remember, we have been discussing or we have been looking at the promise that Jesus made to the disciples, the promise of the Holy Spirit. And Jesus told them that it is to your advantage that I leave, because when I leave, I will leave to you an advocate. I will leave to you a helper. I will leave to you a comforter. And that is Jesus Christ. And that is the Holy Spirit, sorry. And this is a gift that we were given just freely. And now here Jesus have resurrected, and he is insisting, or he is continuing to emphasize or re-emphasize the importance of the Holy Spirit. And he's telling his disciples that when this Holy Spirit will come unto you, he will enable you to go out there and spread the good news without fear. Remember, it was the Roman government, or the government at that moment, did not want people to preach the gospel, the good news about Jesus Christ. They wanted people to keep quiet and not to proclaim the goodness of God and that Jesus had resurrected. And Jesus Christ is continuing to emphasize that when the Holy Spirit will be sent unto them, they will be able to go not only around where they were, but they will be able to go all over the world proclaiming the word of God. God's servants do not all possess the same gift, just as the disciples, but they are all his workmen. Each is to learn of the great teacher and then to communicate what he has learned. The disciples were to communicate what they have learned from Jesus Christ, and they had to spread that to the whole entire world. Remember, for 3.5 years, Jesus spent time to train them. Jesus spent time to show them who he was. Jesus spent time to reveal his Father to the disciples so that they can go out there and reveal the same to the world. At this moment, that's what we are supposed to continue doing. We are supposed to reveal who Jesus is. We are supposed to reveal the character of Christ. All do not do the same work, but under the sanctifying influence of the Holy Spirit, they are all God's instrumentalists. When you accept Jesus, when you accepted God to come into your life, there is a part that you should pray in His vineyard. God employs a diversity of gifts in His work of winning souls from Satan's enemy. The devil came into this world. He has stolen a lot of souls. A lot of people have followed him. God is doing the work of reclaiming what he belongs to him. And you can be part of this army. Today, as we are in this world, it is an exciting thing to participate in God's work of drawing people to Jesus. You, with the talents that you have been blessed with the abilities that you have, with the influence, you can be an agent of grace in this world. That's fantastic. When your life is surrendered to God and you are filled with the Spirit, He will empower you. You will don't have to struggle. The Holy Spirit will empower you, and you will do your part in this wonderful work. It will be a wonderful privilege of soul winning. Remember, you will be a workmanship with him. You will be a co-worker with Jesus Christ. He will sanctify you. The Holy Spirit will sanctify you and will sanctify your skills and give you his spiritual gifts to accomplish whatever task he sets before you. Will you today devote your life to the work of winning souls with Jesus? Will you trust that the Holy Spirit will empower you to do even seemingly impossible tasks? Will you ask Jesus to baptize you with the Spirit as you engage in reaching out to the world around you? That is the challenge that I will leave to you today. And my prayer is that you will have a praise for the Holy Spirit, that you will invite him in your heart, that you will encourage others to follow Jesus, that you will encourage others to do the work that we have been left to do. Remember, as Jesus left the disciples, he gave them a great commission of going around the world, spreading the gospel, making disciples, and drawing many unto him, baptizing them, changing their lives. It is an opportunity that he has given unto you to be a co-worker with him. Will you refuse that opportunity? My dear brethren, it is a high time that you accept him come into your life. And you must not preach the way I'm doing. You must not go outside there, take the scriptures, take the loudspeaker and preach. Your life can testify about Jesus Christ. You can live in accordance to the will of God, so that when people around you, the people who are around the sphere of your influence, see you, they will be motivated to live like you. And they will be asking you, why do you live this way? Why are you not corrupt? Why are you living in harmony with your neighbors? And you will have an opportunity to tell them, it is because of the Holy Spirit who dwells in my heart, and it is because of Jesus who came and died for my sake, and that's why I'm doing what I'm doing. It is a high opportunity that we invoke the Holy Spirit in our midst so that he can direct us to the direction of saving souls together with Christ. Dear brethren, as we pray today, let us ask of that Spirit, and may he encourage us and may he guide us into doing what is in accordance to his will. May God bless you, and may we join in prayers, praying for our country, praying for our brethren who are suffering, those who are bereaved, and praying for our neighbors who don't have food. And also remember to share the little that you have so that God will bless you and will bless the others through you. May God bless you. Shall we humble ourselves for a word of prayer? Our kind and loving Master, we are grateful and thankful for this opportunity you have given unto us. Thank you for the wonderful word that we have heard. Thank you for the wonderful gift that you have given unto us, the gift of the Holy Spirit, who comes in our hearts and dwells within us and helps us to work with you in your vineyard. We pray that may you continue being with us, and may you continue invoking him in our lives, so that as we will live in accordance to thy will, O Jehovah God. May you help us to be co-worker in your vineyard, to be soul winners, and to bring many, to draw many unto thee through our actions, through our words, and through our lifestyle, that Jehovah God, it will be for the honor and glory of your name. Thank you for my dear viewer. May you be with him. May the prayers he has posted before thy throne of grace, may you answer him if they are in accordance to thy will, O Jehovah God. The needs and the cares that he has, may you take care of them, because you are God. The burdens that might be in her heart or his heart, Jehovah God, may you enable him to lift them up unto Calvary. And because you have promised us that you take care of them, may you take care of them, O Jehovah God. Thank you because of our country. Thank you for this, Father, you have blessed us. May you continue, Jehovah God, fighting for us. May you continue healing those who are sick. May you continue healing our nation also, because economically we have gone down, O Jehovah God. And Father, at the end of it all, may we stand to proclaim your grace and of your mercies. And may we stand to say thank you for the way you have been with us and the way you have made us victorious. Thank you because you have heard our prayers. May you continue being with us, and may you continue sending the Holy Spirit to abide with us. It is in that wonderful name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ we have prayed and given thanks. Amen. Thank you, my dear viewer. May God bless you. May God abide with you. And even as we continue worshiping God, may we continue worshiping him in truth and in spirit. I would like to request that may you continue sharing these messages, so that as you have been touched, they can touch others, and also they can be drawn closer to the kingdom. It is in the mighty name of Jesus Christ I pray that may you abide in his grace, and may you remain safe in Jesus' name. Thank you. God bless you.